Good teaching is good teaching. If we want our students to be involved in good teaching, we have to provide teaching opportunities for staff as well. And professional development is really where we need to begin. In order for it to change, it has to change in the classroom. Some of our teachers don't know any better. They don't know that there's a different world other than their worldview. They don't understand instructional strategies that need to happen in the classroom. And they're not aware of the cultural needs as well. So providing professional development is critical if we want to move forward success for all of our students, and we want to educate all of our students about the history of Canada. I listened to a gentleman speak yesterday, and he talked about the connect from the heart to the mind, and that's really where we have to focus. If we want to move and change mindsets of our educators, we have to touch their hearts, and we have to touch their hearts about stories, about culture. Probably the best professional development activity has happened when they have had an aha moment, when there's been a realization that there's something that they didn't know, and now they know better, and now they're going to do better. Some of our educators are unaware of the barriers that exist for our students. And I think for many of them, they just feel, why can't they be resilient? I was resilient in my life. I went through difficult times, I had hardship, and I still got to school. I still managed to graduate. And I think there's a real disconnect between what our students, the reality of what our students deal with, and what the knowledge is that our teachers have. Part of making sure that we have teachers educated is ensuring that we have student voice. So when you have a student that's videotaped and they're sharing their message about what it's like to ride on the bus from Muscatchees into Wolf Creek Public Schools, what it's like to come from a very small school on a reserve to come to Wolf Creek Public Schools that is a large school that consists, the majority of population is non-First Nation. That's an interesting concept for many of our teachers that they've never even thought about. So it's critical that we have student voice present, not only in experiencing their stories, but also in understanding what they need in the classroom. How do they learn? How do they learn differently from other students? Our Wisdom and Guidance Committee was formed so that we would be able to listen to our parents. They would have voice within our school district. And the voice needed to be a voice that they could share openly in a setting that they were comfortable in. Many of our First Nation students have parents that are not involved to the capacity that we would like them to be involved because we haven't asked them how they would like to be involved. So part of the Wisdom and Guidance Committee is asking, how would you like to be involved? How are we going to move this forward together? How can we work so that we're collaborating with both communities? With the Wisdom and Guidance Committee, the greatest lesson I have learned is the passion and the care that parents have for their students. They want what's best for students, and they're willing to provide opportunities for learning to staff. They are the most amazing group of individuals who are concerned about all students, not just their own. So when we have any initiatives that we're moving forward, many of our parents will say, is that for all students or is that just for focused on First Nation, Métis, and Inuit students? No, it's for everyone. The learning is for everyone. And that's, I think, what brings the forefront for me is the greatest lesson is the passion that they bring and the care, and they really want what's best. To have a key contact across the province, someone that is supporting us in our work as we move forward and support others. And so making change is not easy. Change is difficult for many people. Understanding why they would have to think of a different worldview is absurd in many cases. When I think of the children and the lives that we have touched by doing something different in the classroom, that to me is remarkable, and that comes from your work and your support throughout the last few years. So thank you.